And I love the fact that she's actually introduced this game to schools.
Yes.
Because a lot of schools now in Dagenham, they have this game in their their schools. Yeah. And it's really a lovely way for children to start learning how to budget, you know, how to spend money and understand money management from a very young age. Mm-hmm. So for me, that is such a great, excellent idea that she's introduced it to schools. Mm-hmm. So,
I mean, you know, the thing is that, I'm sorry, with the fact that this game has been produced, I'm really surprised that it hasn't been picked up in terms of government level. Mm-hmm. And the reason why I'm surprised about that is because they're the ones that are saying that they're wanting people to spend their money better, wanting people to know how to save, you know, the interest rates are not great just now, but, you know, they're wanting everyone to look at their money better, because of course, you know, you've got all these people who are on, you know, social welfare and, you know, credit grants and things like that, and yet they're not knowing how to spend their money, and that's what's actually getting them into more debt and more problems. And I think something like this, starting from a children's level, it should be in every school, for goodness sake. Because how else will you learn about money? I know that I didn't get taught about money when I was growing up, and I grew up in this country.
Well, I was going to say, I mean, how much education have you guys all received in this area up to now?
We didn't. I mean, when I was playing with my kids as well, I found that, you know, it's very educational, and I never had that opportunity where I had to learn. I sort of had to make mistakes
and learn.
Through having friends and community like this and playing these games, you now start, you know, re-mending your mistakes and stuff. But with my kids, I think it teaches them mostly, I think what I'm really happy about, the consequences of borrowing and of spending, and also making a wise decision based on their future in terms of investment, in terms of buying properties, in terms of putting their monies, prioritizing, you know, debts as well and stuff like that. I think for me, that's the best education for my kids.
You know, the other thing is that, you know, money is a little bit like sex. People think they know all about it, but they don't know anything about it. And then they're afraid to ask. Sorry. My mind is a bit funny. But it's true. We're afraid to ask, but we think we know everything. And then we make mistakes.
That's the idea for your next game board. Working
on. She's going to help me with that.
But I mean, what kind of conversations do you all have with your kids about money? What comes up most frequently?
I remember, I mean, I met Ariola at the beginning of the year, and it was based, I mean, it was from a letter she sent to my church. I actually, well, I lead the children's church in Sunday school. So she was invited in, and we did have a session with the kids, and not only did they go home and talk to their parents about it, she was invited in to actually have a session with the parents as well as the children. And some of the questions that the kids come up with when we do this, because we've added it onto our curriculum for the year, so we do it once every quarter, is overdraft. What does that mean? So it gave us, the teachers, the opportunity to explain what that means to them. You know, so at least they have that mindset and they understand, oh, if I spend all my money, there's opportunities for me to, but then, you know, you get penalized due to the interest and so on and so forth. So I remember the first time my son and I played it as well. He's, oh, Mom, how much have you got left in, I mean, in his savings? How much have I got left, Mommy? Oh, and we need to save for,
it's the awareness of how much I'm spending as well.
It creates that awareness, which is what I think is really important for our children, so they don't fall into the same trap or mistakes that we did whilst we're now trying to, you know.
I mean, with my boys as well, it's constant now. Mom, how much do you have? No, I don't have how much I have. No, because if you buy this, we know you're not going to get. And also now, before I was very cautious of them having bank cards and, you know, managing their own money, but my 11-year-old can manage his money. I've opened his bank account, it's the last one, and the other one, 13 and 21. And they manage their money more than I do. Yeah. Mm. And it was so funny that their dad went to them and said, can I borrow
$10,000 for interest.
Yeah. No, they didn't ask for interest, but then they are so good of saying, Dad, when are you going to give me this money back if I give you? Can we go to the cash point and then let me get the temper? He kept the receipt that he collected. And on the same day that the dad said he was going to give him back the money, he was there with the receipt
and said, Dad, there you go. You collected
my temper.
Mine actually would ask for interest.
Yeah.
So he would say, how much are you willing to pay on top of what you are borrowing? So of course that would then put you off and say, oh, okay, you keep your money, you know, that would be okay. So it's just lessons.
Yeah.
You know, I mean, that's
starting to teach you guys.
Yeah.